So, Rise of the Skywalker, it's a movie. That's sort of all it is. It's not a very good Star Wars movie. It sort of just feels like they made Episode 7 for fun and thought, oh crap, now we have to make it a trilogy, and scrambled together a plot for 8 and tried to tie it up for 9. Anyway, the acting was good. The sound design and score were neat. And it just felt like a select group of people working on it really cared about this movie. Alright, no spoilers. So the movie starts with Kylo Ren beating up a bunch of random dudes to find this random triangle. And when he finds it, he shoves it into his ship like his mom just yelled at him. And he flies to this place that has just lightning everywhere for some reason. I don't know, it's a dramatic. But he goes down here, sees Palpatine. Yeah, Palpatine is brought back here. Why? Well,
the dark side of the Force is a pathway to many abilities some consider.
He said the line. He said that because he said the line. And of course, he rises a million Star Destroyers out of nowhere. And there's a scene where Kylo and Rey talk like they did in the other episodes. But this time, the conversation ends with Kylo physically interacting with Rey. And he uses the necklace he snatched via an information superhighway, and he uses it to find where Rey is. So they find Lando Calrissian, but he only exists to be a go-this-way sign and nothing else. But oh no, they fall into quicksand that kindly waits for them to notice that they're in quicksand before sinking them. And they fall into an underground cave that could only be possible in Minecraft, where they find a knife that leads them back to the
Big Bad Man.
It's literally just the scene from the SpongeBob SquarePants Christmas special, where Santa sees a robot that says, "Property of the Chum Bucket," but with extra steps. They run into a giant snake thing where it's revealed that Rey has healing powers. Meanwhile, Chewie gets taken away along with the knife by the evil people. So Rey and Kylo fight for the ship, and it feels like a Wii Sports Resort game. Until electricity So the ship gets shot down with the power of the Force, and Chewie supposedly dies. Wow, look, this movie's taking an actual risk. Never mind, he's alive. And the only reason they investigated the other ship was because Rey felt it. What the hell does that mean? Couldn't they have said that she felt him and have it turn out to be wrong? Wait, no, because that might make people upset. So C-3PO says he can translate the knife, but oh no, it's written in Sith language, and he's forbidden to translate it. And Poe knows a planet, but they can't get there. But this guy's a spy because he doesn't like Kylo, but he wants them to shoot him in the arm so it looks like they fought him. But he gets shot in the leg instead, and he gets killed anyway, so it doesn't even matter. So they take him to this little drunk guy that's one of my favorite characters in the trilogy. But right before he gets shut down, he says, "I have another idea," which only exists in the movie to piss people off. Also, they try to make this semi-romantic side plot with Poe and this girl we've never met before, but it never means anything. So they learn the location on the knife, but oh no, big bad Kylo Ren is here. So they need to get to the GPS pyramid. So they find the Death Star and it looks like a sunken ship. I didn't know there would be that much rubble left. I thought it went kablooey! And I guess the waves are always huge here. So Rey just decides to like go through the waves and she gets through them no problem. So once she gets on the ship, she finds herself but a baddie. Which, might I add, is just a worse version of this scene from episode. So Kylo Ren is here too, oh no, and he doesn't want her to get the GPS triangle, and he wants her to join him so they could overthrow Palpatine, so they could be the
rulers of the universe.
So they fight.
There's a lot of cheating in there, a lot of they fight, for 20 minutes, just says they fight.
But oh no, he crushed the GPS triangle. So once they're done fighting, Princess Leia dies and Kylo Ren feels it. By the way, in this whole movie, Leia is just deleted scenes and reused footage from the previous two films. And they wrote around the dialogue they had, and it just felt really distracting. So anyway, in this moment of weakness, she stabs him. And I guess it took longer for the feeling to reach her because she's not the newest model, so she can't receive 5G yet. But anyway, remember the healing powers they had from earlier? She heals him, so they stare at each other before Rey just leaves. So in this moment of reflection, Kylo talks to his dad that he stabbed, and they recreate this scene. And when I was in the theater, I almost laughed out loud at the idea of Kylo just stabbing him again. But he doesn't, and we're greeted with Rey burning Kylo's ship on Luke's island. She talks to Force Ghost Luke, and remembers the GPS triangle would survive the fire.
Bro, he's pulling the X-Wing out of the water, I'm gonna poop myself, where's my diaper?
So she uses the GPS triangle to get to the lightning planet. And it's here on the lightning planet that we learn every Star Destroyer has Death Star capabilities. I can only imagine J.J. Abrams sitting in his room going,
yeah, so what if we took a Star Destroyer and gave her a planet blower upper? But yeah, what if we had a million of them? Yeah!
So we're back to C-3PO with no memory, and I thought, wow, this movie is taking an actual risk. But no, he gets it back almost immediately, and the entire time he does have his memory lost, he just goes, hey, I don't remember anything, remember? So Rey finds Palpatine and has an interview with him, and here it is revealed that she is a Palpatine. So I guess that explains why she's basically the Superman slash Captain Marvel of the Star Wars universe. Meanwhile, they realize that they could screw up the ships with this singular giant central antenna. But their move gets called and radio tower gets relocated. So they have to land on the ship, or else. But oh no, they moved it to another ship. So after this game of pinball, Lando brings a bunch of ships and a battle commences. This scene suffers exactly the same problem as Age of Ultron.
Sensory overload!
And in the elegant words of Ralph Seppi,
it's a giant fucking candy bar! It's just too much!
So Kylo shows up without the GPS triangle. I guess he just had the route memorized in his big old noggin of his. Kylo warns Rey that if she kills him, her spirit will go into him, which doesn't make sense. So they bicker over who dies and who doesn't. And they come to an agreement right when Palpatine remembers that he could suck life forces like a Dementor from Harry Potter or something. After he's had his fun with that, he shoots out a lightning bolt that Thor would be proud of. To disable all of the resistance ships temporarily. I guess that's what he needed the life forces for. Then they have a scene which basically just recreates the I Am Iron Man scene from Endgame. But oh no, Rey couldn't take the power and dies. Wow, look, this movie's taking an actual risk. Wait, no, we couldn't kill off someone who's been the hero the whole time. So they kill Kylo instead. But not before they kiss, because J.J. Abrams was getting some death threats or something. So he evaporates like a Jedi, which I guess I really like, because it's sort of subtle instead of them just saying, oh, you're a Jedi now. I just had him disappear like Obi-Wan does and Yoda does. So she goes to Luke's old planet where she buries the lightsabers just cuz, and it's here where she gets asked her last name. I swear to God, I'm gonna be so mad if she says Skywalker.
Rey Skywalker.
She said Skywalker. She said Skywalker. Of course she said Skywalker. I'm done. I'm done with this. And the movie ends with a direct copy of this shot, except the lighting isn't as dramatic and it has no heart. So overall, this movie has its highs and lows. The lows mostly overweigh the highs, but there were highs. And I didn't notice anything neat with the cinematography. Nothing felt like it really mattered. There are no stakes, death means nothing. I'd give this a 4 out of 10.